efficiency is in the eye of the beholder. And the quickest thing, well, there's a couple of options. Number one, if you want efficiency, maximize what you do at your work session. Maximize what you do at your work session, because if you feel like you're getting into the regular meetings and the meetings are going on endlessly and there's too many unanswered questions and things are unclear, it's probably because some of the heavy lifting wasn't done around this table. Now, that may be unfair of me, but that would be at least one thing I might offer up to you. You know, if you want to talk about some additional procedural tools to try and guide that efficiency, we can do that. But I think the better thing to do would be to exploit the work sessions. And I think the other thing to do is it's going to come as you coalesce as a commission. As you work together more, as you come together more, you may go through tough zonings more, almost like an esprit de corps that will sort of accompany you. And I think that's going to lead to efficiency as well. Yes, sir.
Kind of following up on that, I'd like to commend my fellow commissioners here for putting up with me from time to time when I get going. And I think that y'all have all been mighty kind, to let me speak sometime ad nauseum. I'm working on that and I'm trying to shorten what I say. And but up to this point, I feel like that y'all have treated me very, very fairly and given me time to do that. And I'm gonna try to respond in kind and be quiet. Not be quiet, but not go on and on like I'm known to do. So, but I just want to thank you all. This is a good opportunity to do that.
Yeah, and that's it. Yes, sir.
Can I get you to weigh in on one of my favorite subjects? Is you think I know what my is conflicts of interest. Okay. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Well, with respect to zoning actions, conflicts of interest. Well, there's two things we need to keep in mind, and I think we've discussed some of this previously, but I'm happy to go over it again. I think with respect to conflicts of interest, we've got the zoning procedures law contains specific safeguards with respect to a conflicted vote. Typically, with respect to things, if you or a family member have any sort of a financial or personal interest in the matter that is coming up before you for zoning action. Supposed to announce, you're supposed to provide a written document evidencing that you have a conflict, and you're supposed to recuse. We also have in Forsyth County, we have an ethics code, which is actually more broad than just the zoning procedures ethics rules. And it basically says, I can't summarize all of it in one little sound bite, but it basically says that if you are considering taking action on a matter where you cannot make an objective, neutral, and unbiased decision based upon either a personal affiliation or a financial affiliation, then you should not take that action. And you should, again, announce, and you should recuse. And you know where I stand on that. I hope all of you do. And I think that you need to give those considerations full play in every zoning that comes up in front of you. I think most of you try to do that, the ones that I've had encounters with and experience with. I know that you're trying to do that, and I know that the Board of Commissioners attempts to do it as well. But they're serious, and a conflicted vote in a zoning matter can actually render the entire zoning void, invalid. Just something to keep in mind. There's plenty of case law on that, and I think I've used this analogy before, but typically ethics is sort of a bright line. And no one ever fell off a cliff 30 feet away from the edge, right? So you try to keep back a little bit.
Can you have a conflict of interest if you don't know that you got a conflict of interest? Can you have a conflict of interest without knowing that it's actually a conflict?
Well, I'm going to answer the question, but let me get out my explanation. The whole point of a conflict of interest is that because of the relationship or the financial interest or what have you, your ability to make an impartial, neutral, and objective vote fulfilling your civic obligation cannot be taken, because you are making your decision based upon what? Something other than your civic duty. So if you don't know you have a conflict, you don't know, wait for it. If you don't know, can you be guilty of an unethical act if you didn't even know enough to be able to take that sort of a conflicted decision? You would think the answer would be no. But I think at the end of the day, the better approach is that if you have a conflict, and even if you weren't aware of it at the time, I think the end result will be the law won't care.
So ignorance of a conflict of interest is not an excuse for...
Yes, that's what I believe. Not a conflict that's sort of one of those, you know, we've talked about them in here before, sort of an appearance of impropriety. I'm talking about if you have a disqualifying event based upon a spousal or some sort of a familial relationship, and you may not have been aware of it, I don't think the law, if for instance, if there was a challenge to a zoning by a neighbor who says you had a conflict, and the answer from you is I didn't know I had it, I don't think the court will care whether you knew it or not. If there is truly a disqualifying conflict, I don't think the court would.
But probably the best way, let me go on, to discover if you have a conflict of interest is to identify all the parties affiliated with an application.
That would seem reasonable.
Would that be proper?
That would seem reasonable.
So you should, because I've thought a lot about that, and I've kind of brought that up a few times. And somewhere along the line, maybe some point in time, we can, when somebody's presenting an application to the Planning Commission, I think it should be accompanied by a rezoning affidavit package explaining who the parties are so that we don't run the risk of having a conflict of interest.
And this is where you get into that balancing issue, because on the one hand, we have ethical duties, and then we have duties under the UDC. And on the one hand, we're supposed to make land use decisions and recommendations based upon the public policy of land use. On the other hand, to the extent we have ethical obligations, we're supposed to make those based upon who is in fact impacted by those land use decisions. And so we have to keep those allegiances clear, but yeah, your point's well taken.
Okay, good. I might bring that up, but maybe put it on the agenda or something to discuss it next meeting or something.
Madam Chair, unless there are any more questions from me, there is one other topic, but I want to defer to Mr. Brown on that. That is the extent of my bullet point cheat sheet.